I commanded to stand up. Amen. And the people worship God about 1 o'clock tonight. It's supposed to finish about 10. Amen. And I tell the pastor, take a worker and that wheelchair, put it in your church and live it there and let them know that Jesus is still in the business of healing.
Yeah.
Yeah. Amen.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. So the 15 pastors there saw the miracle and they told the bishop, I want this man come into my church. And that's my entrance to preach. And when I went back, I preach. When I preach, brother, I don't call you back again. Amen. Ask pastor, he can call me several times, but he can't find me. Because I'm a busy man. Amen.
Yeah.
I have more than one phone, so if you call me, you may not call me on the right number. Amen. And that's how I operate. Hallelujah. And when I went there, not knowing that God would have me to stay in America. Amen.
Great.
I've never planned. Amen. So when I reached there, the Lord showed me on two occasions I was reaping in a field and the fruit were ripe. The first time I shared with one of my bishop friends and he told me, say, brother, you have some work to do in this country. And the Lord again came back to me and take me back to that field and show me I was reaping, I was picking fruit. Amen.
Amen.
And shortly after that, the Belgian pastor called. He said, where are you? I said, I'm in New York. He said, man, from since you preach, I've never seen you. I'm trying to ask for you and I can't find you. He said, but we were fasting and praying for somebody to preach in our anniversary. And you came up in my spirit. Every time I go to pray, you came up in my spirit. But where could I find you? And I said, I'm here. He said, well, I have no doubt that you is the man to preach. And I preach in silence. I take the opportunity and preach in silence. Saw miracles and signs and wonders take place. Amen. There is a witchcraft woman came inside thee, lay hand upon her, cast out those demons. And this woman was the entrance to get me to start ministry. She had about 12 people. You know, they have the people walking with them. Amen. She had about 12 people. She bring them back the next night, pray for them, get them delivered. She had a place, she tell me, you can use my place. Teach them, Pastor Levo, teach them the way of the Lord, baptize them,
yeah.
And the ministry starts. Amen?
Yeah.
And that's how we start. And brethren, my mission is not about money. I don't go to America for money. Everything I do in America is free. I'm the only preacher preaching in America, and I ask you for a cent. Amen? Hallelujah. Because when he sent me, he promised to provide my need.
Yeah.
Amen?
Yeah.
My license minister with the city, I do wedding, I do different thing. I go in different departments and pray with people in the city. And they will just ask me, how much you charge? I say, if you want to give an offering, you feel free. And let me tell you something, Pastor, if I gave more money, more than anybody charged.
Hallelujah.
You see, amen. When the time comes, amen, I establish the church, move there, and go to the other side, and establish the other church. Amen. When the time comes for me, I believe it was 10 years I'll stay there. I stayed more than 10 years. I spent 14 years there, and it was not the way. Amen. Pastor before had the confirmation of the vision that God told me for Trinidad. He called me and told me that. Amen. On two occasions. And I get confirmation when I come into the custom confirmation. And God, amen, I'm here not to be a visitor. I'm come here to work.
Yeah, hallelujah.
Amen. Hallelujah. But that is not my message. The Bible says that Jesus Christ, amen, he went to the wilderness. to be tempted by the devil. He was led by the Spirit of God. You know, sometimes when the Spirit of God operating is contrary to the natural.
Yeah.
And that's why some people don't receive anything, because it like nothing, it's foolishness. And so Jesus, amen, was led after the baptism and went in the, amen, to the desert, amen, to the wilderness. And the Bible says he remained there 40 days and 40 nights. Hallelujah. And on three occasions, the enemy came to tempt him, because the enemy wants worship.
Yeah.
Amen. So he came in the flesh. If you want to know Jesus, only the Holy Ghost that know Jesus and the Father.
Yeah.
And people today are confused still. The religious world are confused still because they don't know Jesus.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
God.
And I tell people, your religion cannot make you know Jesus. You gotta receive the Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
Amen. So the Bible says he came. Amen. From the temptation, after he went, amen, he defused the enemy. Hallelujah. It was time for ministry. And so when he came to, amen, and he went to the temple, amen, as it accustomed, the synagogue as accustomed. And the Bible said that he opened the book. Usually read that, amen, open the book to read. And he read from the scripture, where he taken from the, amen, the page of Isaiah. And the Spirit of God is upon me. Amen.
Yeah.
Because he have anointed me,
yeah,
to preach the gospel. I love how he put it there, preach the gospel. We have people today who they say that Jesus called them. But amen, there's no anointed. And a matter of fact, that if nobody, if you don't anoint it, no good. Because the devil have already wrapped up and tied up. Amen. But the devil prayed when a man anointed by God for the purpose of preaching the gospel. Because I've learned that the gospel, amen, is the power of God unto salvation to them that believe. Amen. And I believe that, amen, that Jesus Christ came and he said that the Spirit of God is upon me. Oh, that Spirit that was in the beginning with the Father. Amen. Hallelujah. When the world was created and God said, let there be light, and there was light. I want to let you know that Jesus' name in heaven is not Jesus. He is the Word. Hallelujah. So when God spoke the Word go forth, and that was Jesus and the Holy Ghost in the creation order and create, amen, all things by him. And that's why, amen, hallelujah, Paul said, all things were made by him. Without him, there were nothing made. Because it's Jesus Christ in him is life. And the life of him is the life, the life of him is the life of men. And that's the Jesus we serve. Amen. I come for us to have a good time. I come to see God work. Not I, but Christ in me. I want to see him. I want to see where's the bed. I believe in the letter. Cleansing. I believe in miracles and signs. I believe that there's nothing impossible with this God I saw. Amen.
Praise God.
Hallelujah. The majority of people that came from a church, amen, in the U.S. and many places from other church, they received miracles. Because I don't believe I saw a dead God. I believe that he left, amen, he gave me the anointing to function like him.
Amen.
Amen. I don't play around with people concerning the truth. Amen. I don't play around with preachers who play around with the truth. Amen. If you can't keep you here, then you're not walking in truth. Amen. That's, yeah, amen, the biblical principle. But the Bible said that, amen, that the anointing of God, that same anointing was with Abraham. That same anointing was with Moses in the wilderness. That same anointing was with Elijah. And amen, Elijah Elisha, the prophet of old. That same anointing was the anointing that came on Samson when he fought against the Philistine. Amen. When he used the jawbone of an ass and killed 5,000. That same anointing that caused one of the fur in the jawbone of an ass when he drank when he was thirsty. That same anointing that was with Jonah when he went to Nineveh. That same anointing that was, hallelujah, with all the great prophet of old. Hallelujah. What the children but God under the Old Testament, everything foreshadowed about one man to come. Yes, I said he was wounded for my transgression. And he was bruised for my iniquity. Which is why that my peace was upon him. But now he strived. Could somebody say praise God? I tell Pastor, if I come into preaching, what you tell me to preach? Amen. Hallelujah. And so that anointing was upon him. Amen. The Jewish people didn't know this Jesus. Amen. And you see, when God walked, God take people from nowhere. Amen. Yes, I come from the lowest gang. Amen. God met me on a night when I was going to kill my best friend. Hallelujah. And burn the house and kill every one of them. I grew up in fight. I grew up, I love to fight. Amen. Hallelujah. But thank God that Jesus Christ, the preacher cannot hit me again. The preacher, amen, could have preached because I read the Bible when I was 8 years old. Hallelujah. But God, hallelujah, hand was upon me. And thank God he saved me from a little thing. I could have died a thousand times, but I don't realize his hand was upon me. Amen. And I thank God today that he's alive. Oh, but somebody praise God. It was Jesus I'm talking about. Did they know who this Jesus? And the Word become flesh and dwells amongst us. Where did God ever say that Mary full of grace? But I tell you, that's a lie from the pit of hell. But the Bible says he's full of grace and truth. Amen. No man come unto the Father but through Jesus Christ. That's the God we serve.
Yes.
And he came, and the people was going in the temple, and they were going in, and they were coming out of the temple with their sin. They were coming with the load and the burden of care. And the priest upon his rooter, and amen, the priest will ungrove. And when Jesus, the anointing, came, where he bring it, expose them, and let them know, hallelujah, that you are a bunch of hypocrites. And they get to hit him. You preach the truth and the devil get mad at you.
Amen.
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 Hallelujah. But the Bible says the anointing of God was upon him.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. And he was anointed to preach the gospel. Oh, the first Adam caused the human race to fall in sin. But the second Adam, amen, came with that quickened spirit, amen, to save the world. I thank God I'm a part of it. And the Bible says that he anointed him, amen, to preach the gospel and to heal the brokenhearted. And I want to say something about the brokenhearted. Many of you in church today, but you have some past inside that you will get healed from. Amen. That's why some people pass the level. They behave as how they behave because they're broken inside. Some of you was abused when you were a young child. Some of you was abused. You were abandoned. Some of you, amen, hallelujah, were brutalized by your friend, amen, in your school. And amen, hallelujah, your mother and father broke up and you had a broken life because children need the love of their both parents. Amen. And so, as I talked to, amen, to a surgeon doctor that, amen, do surgery broken heart. Even the Christian, he told me, Pastor, I've performed hundreds of surgery, and I've never reached a place to find out where the broken heart, so we could mend it, because nobody could mend the broken heart. Or you can go by the witchcraft, but there's no remedy. Amen. Hallelujah. Some of you broken and alone, and you go to another man or another woman, that's not going to solve your problem. Because when your heart is broken, it is broken. And there should be anointing in the church to bring healing to this people that is broken, Pastor. Yeah. Amen. Yeah. Hallelujah. And amen. Some of you, amen, you've been abused. I was abused, and amen, by my father. Hallelujah. Run my mother with cutlass of a young child. Amen. And I decided one day,
Jesus.
And I saw my mother go through after making 16 children. I'm the age of the 16. And every time my brothers and them get beat, my father will confuse them. And they will just leave. And I decided I'm not going to leave them. We want to die together. Remember one day, Pastor Lefo, it gets so mad and break a chair in him. Amen. One of the most disgraceful things for a man to beat his wife. Amen. And parents will be fighting. Amen. I hate that. And so that, amen. And when the time comes, I mean, hallelujah, my mother tell me, don't do that again. Amen. And I said, when my mother died, I'm going to live greater for God. Amen. When my mother died, she died with cancer. And I left Grenada as I've made my wife a Trinidadian. She was a transport to Trinidad. Met her. Amen. And we came to Trinidad. Amen. They say when you're living, throw two little stones behind your back. And that's what I did. Not going back to Grenada. Hallelujah. Amen. When I, amen, God saved me, the first place that God told me, you gotta go back to Grenada. And I wrestled with God for 8 years because I don't want to go back there. The memory is too hard for me to bear it. And I realize why some people wouldn't want to go back to some places, because the memory seemed to haunt you. And I tell you that, hallelujah. When I get saved, I had to wrestle with that and get healing. How I take the anointing of God to bring the healing to my life. Hallelujah. My heart is whole. And I plan that how my father treat my mother, but never treat my wife differently. And my children. God saved me and called my children to be in this country and separate me like Abraham. Amen, amen, his family in the land of Uz, where he take him from and bring him to Canaan. And so that God called me by his grace, and amen, I start praying for my father. And amen, minister, amen, and get my father to minister to him. Amen, praise God. And brethren, some of you here that you struggle with the same, amen, thing that you have in your life. Some of you people say bad things about you and it hurts you. Amen. But I want to let you know tonight, today, that there's healing in this house for everyone that is broken. Amen. And I'm the preacher, when I call you, when I say, okay, I want you to come, don't sit down there. And when I finish, you pray for me. No. Come when the anointing is flowing. Because too many people in the church is broken. Amen. Some people sit down, amen, and rather to be broken. Anytime something broken, it can't stay inside. You know why some people talk and they cuss and they get them? It's because they're expressing themselves. And I'm the preacher, I listen to people, and as a God spirit calls me to listen, to pick them up what they're going through. Amen. And I want to let you know today that there's healing in the house for you. Amen. God have a gift in you to be used. And the reason why people not being used by God, because they yet been broken, they need to be healed. when Jesus came, he started with the healing. Healing the broken heart. Hallelujah. The preachers, I met a minister in the U.S., in Grenada, different places. They were broken. God used me to minister to them. Some of them was on the brink. The marriage was torn apart. But God saved it. Amen. Children were broken. And God saved them. Today, I want you to stand. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And could a musician just come and play? He touched me. Oh, he touched me. Hallelujah. I want you to pray softly. Hallelujah. And as a musician play, I want everyone to close their eyes. And I want you to be honest to yourself. If you're here today and you're not saved, you need to get saved. Hallelujah. Praise God.
I agree. Come in.
Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah. And all those who hear the message, I want you to come to the altar. You know what type of healing you need. Come.
Hallelujah.
Don't look at me. I'm not the healer.
Thank you, Jesus.
Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. Only touch me. The anointing of God is for you. God, it's God's desire that you get healed. It's God's desire that you get healed. Praise God. Bring you here. Bring you come here. Praise God. Maybe some of the others have come and just stand behind me. If anybody fall here, I don't want you to let them down on the ground to bust their head. Amen. To fall. I want you to try and keep them. Hallelujah. Let me pray for this young lady first. Praise God. Listen to me. God will fuck you in your mother's womb. God wants you to live. Amen. And God is going to heal you. I want you to believe what I'm saying. I don't want you to reflect on your feeling. I want you to believe today that God is about to heal you. Praise God. I want you to lift your hand. Father God, today, this is your time. Satan, you have a plan, but God is greater. And the same anointing that is of Jesus, that same anointing that we functioned, and this anointing came to heal every man of sickness and disease. Father God, I cross every sickness and disease in this body. I charge it to go. I charge it to leave this body. I command it to be healed right now. I speak divine healing to flow. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Oh God, right now, I release your anointing, God, in the name of Jesus. You may hold. Be made whole. Be made whole. from the crown of the head to the sole of the feet. Oh God, I speak that every tissue in the body, oh God, I command, oh God, a body and every organ to be made whole. I don't care what the doctors say, but what Jesus says is final. You are healed in the name of Jesus. Come. Hallelujah. Lift your hand to heaven, Father God. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Someone stand behind me, please. The bus will come. Praise God. I'm going to blow upon you right now. That flow, that blows the anointing. Praise God. Come, somebody else come to help. Lift your hand. Lift up your hand to heaven. Father God, in Jesus' name, I command healing to flow right now. From the crown of the head to the sole of feet. I loose her right now. Holy Ghost, in Jesus' name, touch her. Mercy in the name of Jesus. Be made whole. Be made whole right now. Be made whole right now in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name, be made whole. In Jesus, be made whole. Jesus. No more Jesus. In Jesus' name. We made whole. In the name of Jesus. 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 Father God, in Jesus' name, not by mind, not by power, but by your spirit, said the Lord. I command my brother to be healed right now. Oh God, in the name of Jesus, I release your anointing and touch you. In the name of Jesus, he touched you. Loose him right now. Be made whole. Jesus. Hallelujah. Father God, in Jesus' name. God, you made it whole. You restore the memory, the mental part, the speak down, God. You will touch and release your mountain of God to break every yoke. In the name of Jesus. Jesus, somebody else come. Praise God, praise God, praise God. Father God, in Jesus' name, heal that son right now. I break every shackle, the mind of something little, and I command him to loose by the power of the Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus. Anointing, 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 anointing. Break yokes right now. And sing in Jesus' name. Touch me. Come, next one. I made me whole. He touched me. Oh, he touched me. Right where you're standing. Jesus. He's touching right now. He's touching right now. Be made whole. Be made whole. In the name of Jesus.
And I,
hallelujah,
I
know. Answer in Jesus' name. Jesus. My God, I speak divine healing to move in the body, in the soul, in the mind, in the spirit, in the name of Jesus. Jesus. Father God, touch the child. I command him to be whole. Be made whole in Jesus' name.
Touch me.
Be made whole in Jesus' name. 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 Oh, she got a younger of a single motion. Be loose and be healed right now. In the name of Jesus. Thank you. That's
what.
Touch me, touch me. Let
your
hand to heaven.
I know,
Father God, I come in sight. I lost every demon in a vision. I speak with your touch and release your anointing upon the body. I command the very Spirit of God to be the ruler right now. In the name of Jesus. Jesus. Oh God, you the same miracle. what you've got.
I know.
I come and heal the floor right now. Oh God, in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
I come and let you be whole. Right now in Jesus' name.
Thank you.
out of every struggle, every brokenness.